shall cross the barren desert, but you shall not die of thirst. You shall wander far in safety, though you do not know the way. You shall speak your word
when he was young. He overcame the death of his entire family. He endured the hard life of a labor worker, and he studied in secrecy with the help of his professors. That's how John Paul II's vocation was shaped. His story began in the small Polish town of Wadowice on May 18, 1920. He was baptized 1 month later. He said it was here that his vocation as a Christian and for the priesthood was born. After finishing high school, he enrolled at the Jagiellonian University of Krakow to study Polish philology and also enrolled in an acting school. But the war and the Nazi occupation would change his plans.
Si può dire che la mia giovinezza, no? Anni giovanili sono marcati da una parte da grande provvidenza divina, perché tanti miei colleghi hanno perso la vita in diverse circostanze, nelle guerre, se si pensa di campi di concentramento, se si pensa di questa cosiddetta in ebraico Shoah, vuol dire esterminazione di un popolo, di alcuni popoli. Allora tutto questo appartiene alla storia del nostro secolo, e questa storia io ho vissuto, appunto negli anni giovanili. Ho imparato attraverso queste sofferenze certamente di vedere la realtà del mondo in modo più profondo.
At the age of 19, he started working at a stone quarry and later at a chemical factory in Solvay to earn a living and to avoid deportation to Germany. 3 years later, he decided to join an underground seminary organized by the Bishop of Krakow, Cardinal Sapieha.
Questa esperienza, l'esperienza di un operaio, e nello stesso tempo di un seminarista clandestino, mi è rimasta per tutta la vita. Venendo nella fabbrica per fare il mio turno, 8 ore, di giorno o di notte, ho portato con me alcuni libri. I miei colleghi, vuol dire operai, si sono meravigliati un po', ma non scandalizzati. Mi hanno detto, ti aiuteremo, anche puoi dormire un po' e ti, al tuo posto, cercheremo di sorvegliare. E così ho fatto gli esami anche, gli esami davanti ai miei professori, tutto in clandestinità.
This training, which helped him better understand the world, ended with his ordination on November the 1st, 1946, the Solemnity of All Saints. A few friends and family members were the only witnesses at the ceremony, which took place at the residence of the Archbishop of Krakow.
Poi, non solamente che ho fatto esame, ma ho constatato che questa metafisica, questa filosofia cristiana mi dà una nuova visione del mondo, una più profonda penetrazione dalla realtà. Prima avevo gli studi piuttosto umanistici, attaccati alla letteratura, alla lingua. E qui, con questa metafisica, con la filosofia in genere, ho trovato la chiave per una comprensione, per una penetrazione intellettuale del mondo più profonda e direi ultima.
Carol Wojtyła continued to be the same person he always was, and he kept up his interest in literature and theater. The only difference, the one that would make him become one of the most beloved men in church history, was his faith. He will always be remembered for his commitment to follow Christ, his love for every person emanating from him, and his dedication to children, young people, and the underprivileged.
John Paul II is without a doubt the Pope who has broken the most records in the Church's history. His pontificate is the longest on record. He was head of the Catholic Church for 26 years. Only Pius IX and St. Peter's pontificates lasted longer than John Paul II's. Then he's also the most traveled Pope. He left the Vatican more than 1,500 times for official journeys. He visited 129 countries and traveled more than 1 million kilometers. That's like going around the globe 30 times. If you sum up the time he was on trips, you could say he lived outside of Rome for more than 2.5 years. He also held huge summits in both cities and small islands with fewer than 100 inhabitants. The powerful, needy, the healthy and the sick, the young and old, all paid close attention to Pope John Paul II. The Philippines holds the record for the country with the highest attendance at one of the late pontiff's events. 5 million people attended a mass he held in Manila back in 1995. Nobody in the history of mankind has seen or has been seen by that many people. John Paul II was also the Pope of Youth. He created the World Youth Day, which he celebrated in 5 continents. Aside from being a nonstop world traveler, John Paul II was also a great writer. He penned more than 1,000 pages of magisterial documents, the equivalent of a library with 200 volumes of 500 pages each. His writings include 3,500 speeches from his trips, more than 1,000 of the speeches he made at his general audiences, in which more than 17 million people were in attendance. John Paul II also created the greatest number of saints and blesseds. He raised more people to the altars than any of his predecessors combined, 1,338 blesseds and 482 saints. Carol Wojtyła was also the first on different fronts. He was the first to visit a modern-day synagogue, the first to walk into a Protestant church, and the first to walk into a mosque. John Paul II might have broken many records, but he continued to be who he was, a Catholic priest. He presided over all the sacraments, from baptisms to confessions and marriages, which explains why he liked to describe himself as a simple priest.
Twice yesterday and once again this morning, the crowds in St. Peter's Square, at moments more than 100,000 strong, gazed in disappointment at the black smoke coming out of the insignificant-looking chimney atop the Sistine Chapel. 3 rounds of voting, 2 ballots each time, and the 111 cardinals in conclave still had not made their choice. John Paul I had been chosen on the first day of voting, but those who knew their papal history realized that that was an exception. That usually it takes several days, and there was no telling how long it would be before a candidate received the necessary 75 votes, the 2/3 majority plus one. Then, at 18 minutes past 6 on this warm Rome evening, the chimney came to life again. Just a few puffs of smoke, very little compared with what had come pouring out the other times, but unmistakably white. When Senior Cardinal Deacon Pericle Felici announced the name of the new Pope, most of those in the square couldn't quite catch it. They had been listening for names like Papalardo or Ursi, Pignedoli or Colombo. This name didn't even sound Italian.
Wojtyła.
Carol Wojtyła of Poland, the first non-Italian Pope in more than 4.5 centuries. The papal name he had chosen, John Paul II. The Vatican's Swiss Guard and Italian military units standing by for this moment marched into the square, adding martial sound and bright colors to the floodlit scene. But after the initial excitement, the crowd seemed more subdued than the one that had greeted the naming of Albino Luciani, who became John Paul I a little over 7 weeks ago. One Italian, asked for his impression by a Vatican radio reporter, summed up the feeling of many. He said, after so many Italian popes, it takes a while to get used to the idea. An American in the crowd was less hesitant. This demonstrates the universality of the church, he exulted. When the new pope stepped out on the balcony to give his blessing, the cheering became intense. And as he spoke, in good Italian and down-to-earth phrases, it echoed ever more strongly across the great square. The new bishop of Rome, he said, speaking of himself, has been called from a distant land. Yet it is a land nearby in terms of communion and of faith in Christian traditions. He said he was afraid at first to accept this nomination, but he said, I have done so in the spirit of obedience to the Lord and of confidence in our mother, the Virgin Mary. He started to say, I speak in your language, then corrected himself, I speak in our Italian language. If I make mistakes, you will correct me. Italians in the crowd laughed. Like John Paul I, many thought, here is another pope who can smile. Bert Quint, CBS News, Vatican City.
His pontificate lasted 26 years. We heard him speak dozens of languages.
Lo hanno chiamato di un paese lontano.
And we saw him kiss the ground of all continents and meet all kinds of people. From heads of state to world leaders, from kings and queens to the poor and marginalized. He met actors, athletes, and the needy. We saw his embrace and his smile. We also saw him stumble and struggle. And thanks to this magician and this clown, we also saw him laugh. It was a tradition that happened every Holy Week when college students from all over the world visited Rome for the Univ Conference. And so every Easter Sunday, students would celebrate the resurrection with John Paul II, hoping to make him laugh, smile, and relax. And year after year, they succeeded.
Oh,
Papacy, 83. Un joven de 83 años.
Speak your word.